Hello, today on Typical Books, we're going to have a little bit of a May catch-up. It seems like I just did a catch-up in April, and I'm not really susceptible to this time as a big blur thing during the virus because I have a pretty set schedule every day, and if I don't, then I make a set schedule when I wake up in the morning and figure out tasks to do. So I'm not really that, like, out of sorts. But it does feel like I just did one of these. But there have been a lot of really cool new releases, so I wanted to go over those and talk a little bit about what I'm reading right now. While going through some of my books and deciding what to read next, I was going to read this, but I was hemming and hawing and going over like the first pages of things and saw what caught me the most. And I realized, much to the delight of Andrew from Grumpy Andrew's Horror House, this is a signed copy. I never looked this past the frontispiece. Like, it is signed. So I count myself pretty lucky because I would have never met James Herbert, and I don't have a lot of signed copies. When we go into some more of the upstairs stuff, there's a lot of cool collectible stuff that has maybe signature plates and signature pages, but those aren't like signed. I have some things like Nancy Kilpatrick has signed and things that I've met authors in person, but I don't get out much, right? So this is gold to me, pure gold, considering I paid $7.99. That was my runner-up read over The Pet by Charles L. Grant, and I am totally digging this. This is such a throwback to the horror that I grew up on and the quiet horror that really spoke to me, and it's a little more dastardly than I would have expected from Charles L. Grant. So I'm very excited to become a new Charles L. Grant fan. And yeah, I'm really enjoying The Pet. I think the thing that I'm enjoying the most about The Pet right now is that the main character reminds me of a super young Jeff Dahmer. And not like the Jeff Dahmer that we know from the giant FBI file that maybe I'll do a booktube show on that someday. My husband has everything that you would ever have in a file on Jeffrey Dahmer. But it reminds me of the Jeff Dahmer from My Friend Dahmer by Dirk Backdurf that you may remember from a previous typical book. So as far as what I've been reading, I mean, I've been slow to read lately. I finished playing The Witcher and its DLC components, and I played a little bit of Diablo, but I'm not really into gaming right now. I think The Witcher kind of sucked a lot of that out of me, and I haven't watched the series before anyone asks either, but I really liked the game a lot, and I want to just chew on that for a while, so I'm not going to play any other games for a bit. What I have been doing, though, is writing a lot. I've submitted a couple works. I've submitted work that I had finished writing a while ago. And I'm working on two other stories right now that I really need to buckle down on. So I've been spending quality time writing those. I've got two novels, one on the go, one that's done. So I've been pecking away at those for sure. But of course, aside from all of that, I'd rather be making videos because it's a lot more fun than actually sitting with my bum in a chair all day. And luckily, a lot of other authors have sat with their bums in chairs and brought us some really cool new releases. So, to catch up a little bit, we had left off with The Finders by Jeffrey B. Burton. This is from St. Martin's Press, their imprint Minotaur. And this will be coming out in a month or two. Mason Mace Reed lives on the outskirts of Chicago and specializes in human remains detection. That is, he trains dogs to hunt for the dead. My dream job. He adopts a rescue dog with a mysterious past, a golden retriever named Vera. And I love the cover of this book for this reason. I am a big old Yeller Homeward Bound. We used to own a golden lab. And when Reed begins training Vera as a cadaver dog, he comes to realize just how special the newest addition to his family truly is. Wow, that sounds fun. The Shadow of a Shadow by R.H. Dixon. I really like the cover of this too. It reminds me, it's sort of like this Miss Peregrine's look to it, like Les Mis. Like, I don't know what it is about this picture. It's probably stock, but I mean, who knows? I just really like the design. The typography, I think, is what gets me. Dracula-obsessed Catherine Hall must piece together the disturbing truth of what happened to her runaway cousin, Calanth, in the summer of 2003. Calanthe? Calanthe? Calanth? I'm not sure how to pronounce his name. Because when she visits her aunt's B&B in Whitby, something dark and terrifying is growing in the shadows, something that breathes, something that bites. This is from Corvus Corone Press. by R.H. Dixon. Nice. And His Scream Queen by Brooklyn Ann from Burroughs Publishing. And when Lucio Argento's girlfriend dumps him because she wants to be prom queen and thinks he'll hinder her, he decides to play Pygmalion with outcast Jamie Blair and make a rival for the crown. This sounds a little bit like Carrie. However, when other contenders are brutally murdered, Lucio's quest for revenge is abandoned to protect Jamie and stop the killer. Angelus Rose by Loren Rhoads from Automatism Press. And this book is already out. After their escape from the ashes of lost angels, the succubus Lorelei and the angel Azazel want nothing more than to enjoy each other's company. Unfortunately, Asmodeus, the prince demon of L.A., has threatened to devour Lorelei's new grown soul if she doesn't bring about Azazel's downfall. I have a hard time with demon names, as you can tell. But yeah, this, I thought, from the cover and from the name of it, was a YA novel. Considering all the demonology, I don't think so. It could be YA demonology, like, why not? Jurassic War by John Dennehy. This comes from Severed Press and is already out. U.S. Marines land on a remote atoll to carry out a seek-and-destroy mission. They encounter Japanese infantrymen, and the raiders must also overcome deadly indigenous wildlife. Dinosaurs have not become extinct in all parts of the uncharted world. Turok 2, coming to theaters near you. There was another game trailer for something I can't remember the name of right now. But I was like, is this Turok 2? Is this Turok 2? Every time there's a dinosaur on screen, I'm like, Turok 2? So this might be my Turok. Yeah, I'm just a big holdout geek for Turok. Turok's rising. The Turok cometh. Turok's in the mist. So there you have it. Those are some new releases coming out. I've got some stuff on the go. I have a horror review for The Haunting of Gillespie House, which is long overdue, and it'll be posted either today or tomorrow. And coming soon will be The Pet from Charles L. Grant. If you have anything that you think I should be reading, just let me know. And always let me know what you are reading too, because that fuels my toppling to-be-read pile. Thank you very much for watching, and have an ooky, spooky day.